Oh, so here's what we'll do. We'll back it all the way. And we'll tighten it. Does that make any sense? I don't want to scratch this beautiful aluminum finish, but wow. It says tighten it till you hit the brass. Oh, I am tightening it and tightening it and tightening it. It has not stopped. Holy mackerel. All right, Billy. Let's put some in here. I don't want a tank coming loose and flay it. So we scratched a little, but I don't really give a shit. So now this one is not staying with itself. Screw you. Not spinning with the... See, it's just coming out, see? So that was mine. That side didn't work out well. Damn it. I'm supposed to do this. Let's try it another way. I must be doing something stupid. I don't know. I don't know. At this point, there's 8 pounds of Loctite on it. Which is funny. See, we'll do it this way. We'll tighten it. We'll put this on. This is going to have the brunt of it. It's going to have the more thread. Then we'll tighten it so it comes out of this one. Tighten from this side. Get it? That's what we'll do. So we'll tighten the shit out of it. Now we'll tighten it this way. I'm gonna snap my driver. Right, that's as tight as that is. Should go into the frame. Yep, fits perfect. I'm assuming it goes just like that. I think I can still get the fuel line on there, so don't worry about it. Bag 5-2. Ooh! Screw's in the way. Screw's in the way. What we'll do, since this is harder to get to, we'll put this one on, cut it later. This is a problem. The muffler's in the way tightening this screw, I think. I'm kind of screwed. What's the washers for? No, these, I don't, oh, there's only 4. Alright. So let's get to the ones we can get to. We can get to that one. Red. Yeah. 2.5. Just do a little snug for now. Should line up here. here. It's pretty neat they're using that as a, the tank as a member to hold the frames together also. It's pretty interesting. And the holes line up perfect. Carbon's done right. It's always good. Gosh, heat's on. It's burning up down here. Good window here to see your fuel level. You can see where that damn bolt's going to be. So let's not run one. Oh, these pipes suck. They're huge. They are only held on by two bolts through the motor, two small bolts. I think that's shit. I think the time for a better mounting system for nitro pipes is due. Crack your case and you crash. Motor case, the garbage. They stick out a mile. They're huge. I mean, really, we can't come up with some better tuning for a pipe than these giant things. Holy shit. It's like, come on, dog. Now, knowing this, I could have assembled. I could still do it. Take this off. I'm going to take the tank off. So what I could do is take it off. It's only four bolts. And slip it in. And we might have to. But at least we can do it. Also try the ball driver. This doesn't need to be ridiculous tight either, so. So we can get from here. Nope. Yes, of course it's giving me trouble threading in. So what we can do is try the L. It's going to take an hour. And the L doesn't even fit. So let's do it by hand. Threading in nice now. So I really don't want to do the four bolts for the tank. As lazy as that sounds. Actually, I got some decent torque on that. This L is too big. I can go grind one down in the garage, a different one. It's pretty tight. We're going to call that good. But that's something to remember in the future. Assembling everything. Oh, we're on the skids. Good. I hate how these sit on places. So let's put the skids open. Let's put the L wrenches away. Ah, properly sized skids, Oxy. The Oxy 5, that was one of my criticisms too. The skids were ridiculously small for that size hollow. Looked ridiculous. Didn't look right. You got one going forward, one going back. That's because he designed it with the carbon. Didn't know what he was going to do with them skids. Designed them later and there was no room. So, I tried to pull it off. But that's why you have different brands and stuff to choose from. Different brands, different stuff. Do what you want. What's your tail case? Let's hope that was the magnets again. Okay. So the same. Usually get a CA. Got the CA. It's where you put it in, and you can't, like, yeah, if you get new ones, come with me, clean the jigger. There's glues. Okay. I wonder if I was supposed to put anything in first. Probably. Looks good. Last Thanksgiving, I think I was working on, I think it was around Thanksgiving, on the what's that brand? It's Chinese owned. Just go on top or bottom. Goes like this. You screw it from the bottom. Thank God they didn't use Phillips. That was a Phillips first. This one will turn down to one. Those are some nice beefy skids, man. I feel right. That the super glue is away. Shove these in, shove that in, call it a day. Or these go forward. Oh god, these aren't like ridiculously tight where you can't even move them. I will not talk about the brand. It does that. Where's the oh, it goes on the outside on these. I've never built a heli with skids and a goblin. Never had one with real skids, in other words. I just had the fake skid goblins. You know what I'm saying? So you should have four of these. Four finishing washers. Okay. Throw that away in four grubbies. Because these have a bad tendency to walk off the job site. These little grubbers. Grubber nubbers. Kind of getting bored. I might stop the video. I want to listen to a podcast or something. I doubt many people are going to watch a video this long anyway. Especially, this is not interesting nor informative. I've never built one before, so I don't have all these tips and shit. Or, like, suggestions on missing magnets, sob. I got a lot more to go. Barely touched the surface here. We got the head to build, the swash, links, servos to mount, tail, mainframe. Alright, no need to go to the instructions for that, that's pretty simple shit. Now, if I put this on now, can I still get to the engine backplate? Remember, I got to tighten the clutch. Let's see what happens. How smart is Saab? Damn, smart son. Wow. Let's do it. Good, they use little screws here. People think that's not good. It's actually good. What are they doing here? They're putting spacers between this. Yeah, spacers. Yeah. I got spacers. This is gonna be fun. I hate lining shit like this up. It's because I use skids from something else. Anytime you have a weird shit, when your design sucks, it's usually because they're reusing parts. Mother effer. Son of a beach. Alright, it's going to be easier this way. Got to get Loctite on this thing somehow. Starting to look like an RC car. Not a heli. Oh, that was nice. Just fucking drop on the pipe. I have to hold this with these. So this won't be fun, sticking around with this ever again. Not too impressed there. Guess that was easy enough with the holding the, I'd get the electric out, but I'm already on it, so. I'm gonna drive it home. Not too tight. Bottles in my way. Try that again on this side. Player method again. Oh, I was like, that looks weird. Well, it's not lined up. I was like, man, this looks like shit. Yeah, it's easy holding it with the pliers, I guess. Crisis averted. Looks like shit, though, honestly. It's got the big gap in there in the frame. Because they reused skids from the... look like the old 680 skids. Maybe the new 580, I don't know. The Kraken. I don't know, is the frame different? Or is the frame width on that Kraken, the new Kraken? Is that what it is? Who knows? Do you know? Fuck it, we're grabbing an electric, baby. No. This is smooth. Smooth build, man. Like, just really well thought out shit. The 580, I was fighting a lot, the epoxy. There's just a lot of weird shit. Hard to explain, like, the body didn't fit either. Literally, it was an inch off the front, and he's telling me just pull it tight. See, I'm stretching and cracking the body. You tell me to pull it tight? Are you going to pay for my new canopy? And it had this printed, that's the problem with smaller companies like Oxy. It had this printed, printed mount in the front, and it was soft. And he's saying, just pull it. Yeah, I don't know, bud. You can't just pull it. So that's that. Very nice. I don't have the fan on or anything. So now we're moving on to the transmission, it looks like. Oh, it's got plastics on it. I did this to F with you. Oh god. Alright, it came off pretty easy. This is cool, it's already assembled, got a big ass bearing on top. What do we do? Main pulley already assembled with Loctite. They're showing some brass thing. I don't see no brass thing. Grease. I don't grease my one ways. Yeah, there's a missing washer here. And this goes on. There's a screw. Supposed to be a brass washer. Why don't I have it? What bag are we in? Foam bag 7. They keep changing the side, but they tell you the bag. Just put it always on one side, please. That's not it. 12, 9, 8. Well, if 8's in my hand, here it is. It's got this brass thing. I'm hoping I put the magnets in the trash by accident. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, no idea what those are for. So this goes here. This thing is supposed to go like that. All right, makes more sense. Let's put some trans fluid. And I'm liberal with it usually, so. All right, this thing goes here. Ooh, is that neat? Takes this long bolt. Do not over torque the screw. Why not? I'm gonna break it. I'm gonna break the screw if I over torque it. Let's see. If you don't want the screw over torque, why'd you use a 2.5 head? That's a little weird. Well, I guess they want a decent shaft size. Oh, it's a beauty. It's a beauty, man. Holy mackerel. Alright, here's where we're going to use the full size ones I bought, because they couldn't include those in the kit. Oh, no. So these are the big daddy mounts. We're not messing with no mini servos. You know why? It was cheaper to buy these than more mini servos, which I don't own. So this goes where here? Oh my god, it's like a beautiful puzzle, this thing. Which screws are they? Socket had 2.5 by 8. So it's these. They seem undersized for what they're doing, but there's 3 of them. We're going to use the blue BK servos on here with the fins. It's pretty sweet. So that's cool. That's cool. I bet you the other two are for the front. I had that on one, so you gotta tighten them. All right, then there's this front piece. Metal. Supposed to be in here somewhere. So is this what I paid $30 for? Just those two pieces?
Holy fucking shit. You kidding me?
Boy, you pay for nice design in this company. Fuckers. So what happens here? This thing goes here. Like that.
No washers, just these big mothers.
Just these. God, this is a joy to build. No trickery, there's no weird holding this, holding that. You ever build a Compass Exo? Good God. It's just frustrating. It's like, what part of this is fun? So what we ended up with here is the same old shit. It's the same stuff. So now we have duplicates. I don't need those. This goes on here. Where's the stock one? I want to see the size. So that's the mini. Should I do something weird, like put a mini? A mini with a... These assholes aren't showing me which way goes where. Oh, this, you know what, this bracket, this one's, it's the same either way.
No, it's not.
This side is keyed this way, so it has to go this way. That over there. So that's how this one is. Oh, I just had it. My damn hands. This one goes like that, so it's got that. This. So like that. Those get the finishing washers. 2.5 by 8. Why is there that many more screws? What do we do with these? 1, 2. Why is there 3? What do we do with those? Something's weird. Like something's off. Okay, some moderate tension. Yeah, we got 3 servos there. We got these parts we're not using. Oh God, it's servo time. I hate servo time. See? 1, 2, 3, 4. Where's all my servo screws? Bag 8. Or just... Why do I have those? What are those? And what goes here on top? There's 3 screws left over. 1, 2, 3 there. 1, 2 there. Why is there so many parts? Why is there 3 of these? Oh, did I open the wrong bag? Ah, there's only 2. Why'd they give me that many in here? Losing my mind. Why is there a weird number of 4? Because that's for the back and this is for the front. I have no idea what's going on. As you can see. What's this? Tail case. I keep going to that tail case. So we need a 17 to 18 millimeter servo arm. So this one's going to work. we'll use for the throttle. Alright, let's get our cereals situated. Alright, so could see this ain't gonna reach the fly bar. These were on the logo. These three. Let's use those, they're a known quantity. Whatever the fuck that means. Means I know they're okay. Well, look at that. Full size servos fit in there. Now, I think we can get the servo horns on after. I think. Put these on like this for now. Tell you how much I do hate doing servos. I don't know what it is. Cause you gotta, you're really supposed to have it plugged in and shit and all that other fucking crap. Hold it and do it at the same time. You can work. Just a little thread locker. Same amount of screws. I don't understand. I think there's another bag. I don't even think these are the screws for it. That all the way. All right. Let's let it get centered in here. Do this one down here. Okay. Oh, it's so pretty. These other two, so yeah, I can get the servo horn on there. And the screw, let me make sure. Those are the damn wrench. Yeah, you got a mile, but these are going to be in the way, so. Let's see what happens. You're gonna go like that. Now they go from the outside in. Let's see what happens. Oh yeah, I got a mile still. How about this side? Ooh, it's by the fin. Ooh, what do you got going on here, Sabi? Made for those little shitty servos. That's what it is. Are you gonna be able to? Yeah, you can turn it. Can you get the bolt back in? Just barely. Something about a synergy, man. You don't. Oh yeah, you can get it. No problem. Synergy built. You can get to everything. We gotta find bag 8 or something. Bag 19. What bag is this? 22. Blah blah blah. What the hell is this? 21. Tail band. Wide bar is 22.
18. Bag 15. Bag 8.
What's this stupid thing? What is that? Swatch measure or some shit? Oh, it's to get your sirloins parallel. That's cool. Put it there and you get your... how you get your arms parallel. So we won't use that later. We won't use that later. No, we will. Just kidding. Relax. Relax, people. We're going to do this right this time. We're not going to do the oxy build. Where people are going to yell at me and...